Hello my darlings and welcome to my channel. Today we're gonna have a reading about your person, whoever you're thinking about. We're gonna look at their thoughts, feelings, their intentions or plans towards you. What are they planning when it comes to you? Do they even have any plans about your connection or relationship? You don't have to be in a relationship here. Maybe you just wondering about a certain person, you're maybe admirer or somebody you just met. What are their thoughts, feelings about you? By the way, for all of you who supported me in the last video, I love you guys so much, and that's why I will keep the comment section open, because I want you guys to comment. I want your feedback. Regardless of all this, whatever happened lately on my comment section, I don't care. I just want you to be there and have your feedback so we can exchange energies. It's very, very important for me. Okay. So let's start. We're only gonna have two piles because I have those two hearts, okay, blue and pink. Pile one and pile two. Okay. So choose your heart, choose your pile. And we will start with pile number one. Whoever chose the blue heart, let's see. What is your person thinking about you right now? Person that you're asking of. Let's start with this deck. By the way, for those who are asking about what kind of decks I use, I will make a certain post about tarot decks that I usually use or my favorite ones, okay? If I'm not gonna forget. Let's see pile one. What is your person thinking about you? Their thoughts. Their thoughts about you. Three more cards want to come out. Now let's look at their feelings. Their feelings towards you. Their feelings, pile one. What are their plans for you? What are they planning when it comes to you? Do they have any plan? About this connection? And finally, some advice for you. Some advice for you. Wow, Three of Earth just flew out. Let me leave it here with the advice. What's the advice here? So let's start with their thoughts about you, pile one. What kind of energy you're gonna pick up here? Somebody here wants to renew the connection or take the connection to a new level. Even if things are going well between you, it doesn't matter how long you know this person. You're just curious. If you're just curious, it's your new admirer, then this person wants to come to another level, which is having a romantic relationship with you. If this person you're already in connection with, that means this person wants to go to another level, and it doesn't matter how hard it might be or what kind of difficulties are on the way, they're still willing to try because they're very comfortable around you. They like your company, they like your energy. I even hear they like this peace around you that they have. And it doesn't matter if you're fighting from time to time, okay? For those who were in a certain fight or something didn't go right, this person wants to reconnect with you, maybe even apologize or just tell you how they feel about you. But here a person wants this connection to move forward for pile one. This person, if they didn't see you for a while, they really miss you. If it's a new admirer, they really want your attention. They want to be around. Okay. Now let's look at their feelings for you, pile one. Wow, oh my God. I want to tell you here, pile one, your presence in this person's life, and it doesn't matter for how long or who you to one and to each other, you completely transformed this person's view on life, on love life, on anything. Here, you are something new, something different for this person. They willing to follow you. They want to explore you. They want to go deep into feelings with you. Yes, maybe those feelings right now, they don't even understand their own feelings. They may feel turbulent, or they may feel like they're drowning in those feelings, good or bad. It could be from the highest point where they are so excited and happy to be around you or to love you, to the point when they're very aggressive and even angry at themselves that they love you so much. It depends on each other, like each person's situation here. Definitely there are feelings, but they're more on a certain emotional instability or frequency that is higher than usual and normal. They're not feeling balanced here in this relationship or connection. They, every time they communicate with you or somehow have a contact with you, they change, they transform, they want a change in their life. You make them, just your presence, make them understand life better, or start over, or do something about their life, you both of your lives together. But there are feelings, but those feelings, as I said, are turbulent. They're not stable, which means, yes, this person has feelings for you, but they may come from I hate you, I love you, to I cannot live without you, to like you make me crazy, and all different kinds of emotions here. Okay, if it didn't happen yet, this could happen. If it's a new connection, this could happen eventually, because you are like this transformer for them. Very important lessons they learn with you. And this is regardless of where this connection is going. But let's see, what are this person's plans for you in the close future, within a month or two? What are their plan? Another death card, 8 of cups and 10 of cups. Wow, guys, as I told you, if your connection has ended, this person wants a renewal, a return to you, because they really miss you, and they even want a family with you, a fulfillment with you. They feel like with you they can have this adventurous life. They're never going to be bored around you. Definitely transformation. 2 deaths talks about major changes that they want to make in this connection. If it's a new person, they just want to be filled with this love and take this connection to another level. If it's a person from your past, or somebody you broke up with or separated from, or in a pause, this person wants a renewal. They don't want any ending here. They're not ready for it emotionally. They're, as I said, unstable. This is not the situation when a person forgot about you. Unless it's not your reading or your pile, but if you feel it resonates with you, this person, if you thought they don't care, or they didn't call you for some time or communicate with you, it's just because they're preparing for a certain major events in their life where you are included. You are definitely included in their plans. And whatever they want for themselves, you somehow attach to those plans, okay? And finally, let's look at advice. And that's why 3 of Earth came out. And in this deck, 3 of Earth is like, for me at least, it's like 10 of Pentacles. Because here is a family, here is traditions, love. It's a very positive card, and let's see what's the advice here. The advice here, don't fall for your past mistakes or failures. Why? Because you may see certain patterns that happened before, like maybe people let you down before or betrayed you, hurt you in some way, you were in some toxicity, and you thinking, okay, if this, maybe this person is the same, but guess what? This is a different scenario. You're not playing out the same role. You're not in the same scenario this time. This time it will be different. You're not gonna be hurt anymore. You're not gonna feel as you felt before. You kind of, this connection may remind you of your past, of some devil situation that you had before, of some toxicity. But the advice here is, don't think like every person or every relationship is different. Yes, you could see some similarities, but this is not the case. This person has plans for you, and they're not planning to hurt you or do what other people did for you or didn't do for you. They're planning to do good things, but if you will continuously seeing them as your past connections that didn't work out, you will attract this devil, you will attract negativity or some failures in this connection. It's basically all about you and your view on this relationship. If you truly want this person, don't reject them just because they somehow remind you of something happened in the past, okay? That's just an advice, of course, it's up to you. And finally, let me give you some angelic message here, something from your guides, your angels, dietary change. And look at this, two deaths, we were talking about a certain change. I want to tell you right now, while you listening to this reading, your life, your love life is already changing for better without you seeing it. This is on a spiritual level, an energetic level. There is a change, but soon it will come to the physical. And I hear within 3-4 months, all of that right now is changing will come to a physical. And it says improve your diet and your life will also improve. Because we don't talk about diet right now, but we could talk about relationship. So I want to say change it and say improve your thoughts and your life will also improve. So if you're gonna think negative, you will attract negativity into this connection or past patterns. If you're not gonna do that and feel positive, believing that things may happen here eventually, at least have certain faith or give this connection a chance. If you give it a chance, you'll see how the universe will take this connection to another level and allow you to be happy here. Of course, if you want this person, this is not for all, but if you feel it resonates with you, that's what I channeled for you, pile one. Thank you very much, guys. And I'm going for pile number two. Okay. Hello, pile two, whoever chose this pink heart. Let's see. Let's ask about your person. What are their thoughts about you right now, currently? What are they thinking about you? Let's read their energies, their thoughts. Then let's look at their feelings towards you currently, their feelings, emotions, an emotional level, their feelings for you. Their feelings for you. Mm-hmm. their plans, what are they planning when it comes to you, their intentions, plans? Are you even in their plans in a close future? What are they thinking or planning about you, Pile 2? Their plans, secret plans maybe, I don't know. And finally, let's look at some advice from the universe for you about this connection. Some advice, something you need to know or consider. Okay, so let's start. Pile 2, what is your person thinking about you currently? The World, Seven of Swords, and Knight of Chalices. Let me tell you, they really worry. Here, either the connection was over, or you in a pause, or you at a distance right now, or something negative happened recently, that or you cannot find the common... like you cannot agree on something here, could be even jealousy here, but something's off here in this connection in Pile 2. Either it's you doubting this person, they doubt something, or in general you're not in very good terms right now. You may be upset with one another, but and they're thinking about it. They're thinking that either you owe them an apology or they owe you an apology, and they understand and realize that this connection is not over. This is not a connection that done like for good. No, here some things needs to be cleared out. Even if after that you will decide to move forward, here things needs to be talked about, considered, considering each other feelings, emotions. If you're at a distance, they want to come to you or they want you to come, it depends, okay? But here I see something's off here, and this person is really thinking about the situation between you. If everything's great between you, this is not your pile. Let me see, what are their true feelings for you currently? Six of Pentacles, Queen of Swords, and Four of Wands. It's like they're angry at you. Or maybe they know you angry at them. It depends on your situation. But at the same time, they want to be in good terms with you. They want to fix the situation. So their feelings right now are... there are feelings and they're stable with Four of Wands. But at the same time, some coldness coming. Either it's from them or coming from you. And... they tell me right now, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to fix this. So right now they're not much into their feelings as into how to resolve the problem, the issue, how to... For some, even if they did something wrong, they want to even come to you with a gift or a present or apologies. For everyone's different here. Or maybe just to talk. To have a conversation, to explain themselves. Let me see a little bit more about feelings here. What are their feeling? Yeah, they're trying to stay away from feelings right now or feeling any emotions because they distract them from fixing the issue. They don't want to feel emotions right now. They guard themselves from being over emotional or being over dramatic or maybe even angry at you. They don't want to be angry at you. Maybe they feel that, but they understand that this is temporary feelings that they don't want to feel. And if they feel coldness from you, they also don't want to feel that. Okay, not anymore. Here a person wants to fix the issue. Okay, now let's look at their plans. What are they planning to do about all of that? Thinking and feeling is not enough, right? Right? So what are they planning? Nine of Swords, Ten of Cups, and Two of Wands. They don't know. They are so afraid to make a mistake or to do something wrong. They want to be in good terms with you. They want to see you. They want to talk to you. But they're not sure how you will react. I don't know why, they're kind of afraid to approach you. And when I'm asking what are they planning, they are planning to come back, to show up, to call you or text you, to see you, but they don't know in how to start the conversation. Will you respond? Will you ignore them? Will you block them? Maybe you already blocked them and they don't know how to get to you. What else? What about their plans? Let me look at this deck for a second. What are their plans for you, Piled Soul? Yeah, they're planning to come back. They're planning, but you know what's going on? They want to release first their negative feelings about the situation. Especially if somebody's angry here. They want to wait a little bit for things to cool down. And when they already come, they come with something more stable or more firm, where they know what they're saying, not just they're saying start saying and then they lost, you know, what they were trying to say. They truly scared or afraid to. You are like the Hierophant right now for them. It's like you judging them. Everything that they will do, you will judge or somehow give it a name. For example, they're coming and start talking to you and you say, are you for real? You just coming just like that without even, you know, apologies? Or you, what's going on here? And all, or they come at your door and you say, are you serious? I blocked you for a reason. Why are you here? They don't know what kind of judgment waiting for them and, from your side. And that's why they're planning to come, but they're still thinking about how they should do it. They're very careful here, but they will finally find a way how they can approach you. I ask how much time do they need more. For everyone's different. For some it's 2 days, 2 weeks, up to 2 months, but mostly I hear up to 2 weeks. This is because this is like very warm energies where something just happened recently, not too long ago. And finally, what's the advice for you about this person? If it resonates with you, wow, the world, the tower, a knight of fire. Look at this, you showing your bottom here and here, and you destroying everything. So let me tell you, the advice here is not being afraid to speak out, to say what you don't like in this connection, not being afraid to even leave this connection if needed, just because you some people may be afraid to say something, how they really feel, in order not to destroy it completely, so the person completely will go away. But here the advice is, don't be afraid to turn your bottom to this person, because they deserve it, especially if they deserve it. Why? Let me confirm that part for you. Why such an, you know, brutal advice here, I wanna say. On emotions, on even anger. Why are you doing that? Death. Because the universe wants them to transform. Because if you take them very fast or forgive them in a second, they would never learn their lesson. It doesn't mean you have to be called again, but saying how you want things and actually following, making sure they next time they actually follow what they're saying is very important. Otherwise, you will be in the same situation in a very close time. They're not gonna learn anything. Yes, because this person is very difficult on changing things around them. They're already used to a certain lifestyle that it's difficult for them to change. But for you, they will change. If they really want you, they will change. But if they don't really care about you, let them go. And that's the advice here. Don't be afraid. Yes, stand out for yourself. Don't be afraid to speak out. Don't be afraid to stay on your own, alone. Because no matter what, you will find your stability or your person or healthy. You want a healthy relationship, connection, and you will find it eventually with this person or without them. That's why be confident. Here, your confidence is so, so important, because I hear the justice is on your side. The truth is on your side. And that's what you should know. Yes, Six of Earth. You should be very confident about yourself that this person, if they're willing to change, great. If not, you have all the possibilities, all the looks, and all the prosperity. It doesn't matter what you have or don't have. You have enough to be in a healthy relationship. That's the main idea here. And that's how you should see yourself. You deserve all the best. You deserve more than you can actually see. You worth more than you see, or than you are willing to accept. And it doesn't matter how you look, what's your weight, what's your degree, what's your background. It doesn't matter. The universe sees you and everyone else as equal souls. Understand that, and we all deserve good things. But if we don't allow ourselves to have good things, we get whatever's left. So here, be confident about yourself. Yes, you can hear this person out, but look at their actions, not at their words. Are they really willing to change things around, or they should go for good? Because here, you're ready to let them go if something goes wrong. And finally, a message from the universe, from your guides. Vegetarian, a new way of eating gives you more energy, greater health, clarity, and stronger manifestation abilities. Funny, but this card of vegetarian tells me right now, like, because it's vegetarian card, right? You may get rid of eating, metaphorically speaking, you may get rid of eating meat and just eat vegetarian food, which for me it means it's better to stay alone than being in a bad company. So same thing is here. Yes, it may be difficult not to eat meat if you're not vegetarian, but it's much healthier to eat vegetables. That's how I feel. So if this connection bothers you, if it's not going the right way, you rather reject this connection, get rid of it. Yes, it might be difficult at first, but you'll get used to it. You'll get used to it and eventually even get healthier or get a better connection. That's what this card right now is telling me. Okay? That's what it is. And finally, everything is okay. You are okay. And always remember, if this is your person, no matter how many times you will reject them or you will tell them what you like or don't like, they still will be back, because if it's your person, if you meant to be together. But if you're not meant to be together, no matter how many times you forgive them, they're not gonna change. No, and sometimes, you know, there are certain, I just remember things when a person cannot change, but suddenly they change for somebody else. That's what it is. If they're meant to be with you, they will change. Thank you very much, guys. I love you all. And I'll see you in my other video. Bye-bye.